Let's now have a look at the arithmetic operators on the course, which are these seven. So what is an arithmetic operator? Well, they work on numerical data types and perform some calculation, perform some operation to give you a numerical result. So if you think back to our input process output model, the operator is doing the processing. It's processing the input to give us an output. And really most of these, well, all of these actually work on two inputs. We've got two inputs, they give you one output. The first three in this table we'll just gloss over because they are just basic maths, addition, subtraction, and multiplication. Just to note that multiplication uses an asterisk, not an X like you might write on paper. The next one, exponentiation, is a mouthful to pronounce and spell. This is doing powers. The way you do this in Python is using two asterisks back to back, but in OCR ERL, they'll use this little, it's called a caret symbol. So what this does is raise the first number to the power of the second number. And this is any power, it's not just squaring. Often people associate this with squaring, but it could be any power. So 2^4 is saying 2^4. 2^4 is 2 × 2 × 2 × 2, which is 16. 5^2 is doing 5^2, that is squaring it. 5² = 25. Now, division is a forward slash in a computer. Don't write the divide sign down if you're writing any code. Always do forward slash. Divides two numbers, obviously. But the key thing to point out ahead of quotient, which is our next one, is this always gives you a real output. So the numerical output it gives you is always a real. It's never going to be an integer when it is a forward slash, which is important because something like 10 divided by 2, if I'm using this forward slash, it's going to give me a real no matter what. That's why it gives me 5.0, not 5, because 5 is an integer. However, something like 25 divided by 4 works as you would expect it to. This is 6.25. We have our real component. So this division is sometimes called real division. And the next one, quotient, is sometimes called integer division. And slightly confusingly, the formal name for this is quotient. Like I said, it's also called integer division. That's personally what I call it in my head. But the symbol is div. So when you see div, you think division because it is a type of division, but be really careful. We've got forward slash, which is what you might call normal division. But div is our slightly not normal division because what quotient or div does is it divides two numbers, but removes the fractional part. So in other words, it always gives you an integer. So if I was doing 10 div 2, this is 10 divided by 2, but it's giving me an integer, which is just 5. If I did 25 div 4, I just get 6 because the 0.25 gets removed when it converts it to an integer. So it's not rounding down, it's not rounding up, it's just getting rid of anything after the decimal point. And I would imagine some students aren't aware that the proper name is quotient. Another proper name you may not be aware of because we call it mod for short so often is modulo, also written sometimes as modulus. So modulo, modulus, or mod for short is another really important operator in computer science. This gives us the remainder from a division. So for instance, if I was doing 10 mod 2, this is doing 10 divided by 2. How many times does 2 go into 10? Well, it goes in 5 times. Is there anything left over? No. That's why the actual answer, 10 mod 2, is 0. To use the same example again, 25 mod 4, we've used it in the previous two boxes, is 1. People often think mod is what div discarded. So div discarded 0.25. That's not what mod gives us. It's 0.25 is not our remainder. If I did 0.25 times 4, I get my remainder. But I think it's better to think of it just more simply. You know, how many times does 4 go into 25? Well, it goes in 6 whole times with 1 left over. And the 1 is what mod would give us. So mod is our more confusing one. So let me give you a few more examples to think in your head. I'll give you a second or two to think about it. So what is going to be 14 mod 3? Well, 3 goes into 14 4 whole times with 2 left over. What about 9 mod 5? Well, 5 goes into 9 once with a remainder of 4. And a trickier one now, 5 mod 12. Well, this is going to be 5. And it's trickier because this time round, my first number is smaller than my second number. So what it's saying is 12 doesn't go into 5 any whole times. So therefore, it's not going at all. Therefore, I've got 5 as my remainder. And if it was 5 mod a million, the answer would still be 5. If a second number is bigger than our first number, always the first number is the remainder. But that rarely happens. It's just to point it out in case you come across a nasty question like that. Okay, to focus on mod and quotient a bit more, where would we use mod first of all in a program? Well, a common example is where we are checking to see if a number is odd or even. Here is my code. I'm asking the user for a number. I'm casting it to be an integer. I'm then using an if statement to check to see whether it's even or odd. And the actual check is to go, if our number mod 2 is equal to 0, it must be even. Any number divided by 2 which hasn't got a remainder must be an even number. If it was a remainder of anything else, which is only going to be 1 in this case, it would be an odd number. And really, we can generalize that. So if I was generally speaking, testing if a number is a multiple of another number, it'd be very, very similar code. This code here is checking to see if a number is a multiple of 5. I'm doing the number mod 5. If it's a clean division, if I've got no remainder, it must be a multiple. So for example, 25 is a multiple of 5, whereas 27 is not a multiple of 5 because it would give us a remainder of 2. Where would I use div in a program? Well, we've actually already used it to divide an array into two parts. We looked at this in a couple of our algorithms. Here is one of them here. See if you can recognize what algorithm is being shown here. Well, this is binary search. And binary search works by dividing an array into two parts to find the midpoint. And we can see midpoint is equal to the start and end div 2. We use div because we don't always have a clean division. I want a midpoint to be an index. An index is always a whole number. So therefore, doing something like 9 divided by 2 would give us 4.5. Well, 4.5 isn't an index. I'd rather that becomes 4. So I use div to avoid an error when it gives me an index which is not a whole number. Perhaps more commonly in terms of what you'd be doing in an exam, well, you might be using a combination of div and mod when converting from a small unit into a larger and a smaller unit. So what I mean by this is, for example, going from the number of seconds into the number of minutes and seconds, I would use div and mod to do this in quite a concise way. So before I look at the code, let's just look at the output, just so you know what I mean. It's going to ask me, how many seconds have we got? If I type in 156, 156 seconds is equivalent to 2 minutes and 36 seconds. So we use div to find out how many minutes are in this period of seconds. And then I use mod to find out what is my excess, what is left over when I do this division. So mod gives us 36, div would give us, in this case, 2. So we do use div and mod quite a lot. Just don't forget that mod is our remainder. It's not the fractional part.